Watch therefore, for ye know not what hour your Lord doth come. But know this, that if the good man of the house had known in what watch the thief would come, he would have watched, and would not have suffered his house to be broken up. Therefore be ye also ready, for in such an hour as ye think not, the Son of Man cometh.
The times we are living in remind me of Noah's generation. The Most High ushered in a new era by displaying his glorious power. During the times of Noah, the Most High set the standards on how the future generations would operate. The Most High put an end to the old way of life and started a new era through the life of Noah and his family. Before the Most High put an end to the old life, the Most High made a covenant with Noah, his sons, and their descendants.
And God spake unto Noah and to his sons with him, saying, And I, behold, I establish my covenant with you, and with your seed after you.
Israelites, before the Most High can intervene in your life, a covenant must be established first. Satan and his angels need a covenant before they can do anything to you. The kingdom of darkness establishes covenants through deception. Most people do not read the fine print that ratify a covenant. The fine print gives the workers of iniquity permission to alter and enforce a covenant to their liking. If Satan were upfront of his intentions, he would not be called a deceiver. The scripture says Satan deceived the whole world.
And the great dragon was cast out, that old serpent called the devil and Satan, which deceiveth the whole world. He was cast out into the earth, and his angels were cast out with him.
Once a covenant is established, Satan gains the right to enforce his will in your life. It is important, Israelites, not to establish evil covenants. Presently in our generation, the workers of iniquity want the people to wear a face mask to protect them from coronavirus. The mask does not protect you from the virus. If you read the manufacturer's disclaimer, it reveals the mask does not protect you from any virus. If the manufacturing company warned the consumer that the mask does not protect them from viruses, what is the purpose of wearing a face mask? Why are the leaders enforcing something that is not beneficial to your health? Study shows wearing a mask has an adverse effect on your health. You are inhaling the harmful chemicals from the mask and bacteria your body removes. Many physicians have come forward revealing how harmful wearing a mask is to a person. However, the members of the Synagogue of Satan operating in the CDC enforce the mask wearing. They are deceiving many by telling the people wearing a mask protects them from the coronavirus. If the CDC cared about the safety of the people, the CDC would have stopped their fellow members in the Synagogue of Satan from attacking the people with biochemicals. Israelites, can you discern how Satan is deceiving many into establishing a covenant by making them believe they are helping while harming the people? They create the pandemic, then give the people a solution under a false pretense of saving lives. Presently, the people are being deceived into believing the president-elect will save them. The president-elect was selected to bring forth what Trump could not do. I am sure the people's new savior will enforce the vaccines and more. Israelites, it is wise to listen to the Most High when he said not to set a heathen over you.
Thou shalt in any wise set him king over thee. Whom the Lord thy God shall choose, one from among thy brethren shalt thou set king over thee. Thou mayest not set a stranger over thee, which is not thy brother.
The workers of iniquity only wants to carry out Satan's plans. Somehow the people believe the leaders they set over themselves would save them. Your saviors are the same people harming you. It is time for the people to wake up. Your saviors create the problems and give you a solution. Our present world condition is a great example of how the kingdom of darkness enforce wickedness under false pretense. The workers of iniquity attack the people with the coronavirus. Social distancing, wearing a mask, and a vaccine is the solution to the so-called pandemic they deliberately started. Discernment with the guidance of the Holy Spirit is key in these last days. Israelites, it is important for you to understand how the Most High put an end to one era to start a new era. A sign of a new era is when the people's wickedness is at an all-time high and destruction is everywhere you go. When calamity happens, a major shift follows. The inhabitants of Sodom and Gomorrah is a good example. The wickedness of that generation reached an all-time high. The Most High judged the people by raining fire and brimstone upon those cities. Abraham's nephew Lot, who dwelt in one of those cities, had to start a new life in a different country.
And he looked toward Sodom and Gomorrah, and toward all the land of the plain, and beheld, and lo, the smoke of the country went up as the smoke of a furnace. And it came to pass, when God destroyed the cities of the plain, that God remembered Abraham, and sent Lot out of the midst of the overthrow, when he overthrew the cities in the which Lot dwelt. And Lot went up out of Zoar, and dwelt in the mountain, and his two daughters with him, for he feared to dwell in Zoar, and he dwelt in a cave, he and his two daughters.
Presently, the kingdom of darkness is looking to do a new thing in our generation. Always remember, the kingdom of darkness imitates everything the Most High does. Satan used destruction to cause rebellion against the Most High and to increase his army. The Most High used the chaos created by the kingdom of darkness to judge the wicked. For Satan to manifest his will, destruction, death, and oppression brings the chaos he seeks to enforce his agenda. Through the chaos, the synagogue of Satan weakens the people. An economic collapse, division, pandemic, and intimidation is a strategy the kingdom of darkness used to weaken the people. The scriptures reveal a kingdom or household divided cannot stand.
And Jesus knew their thoughts, and said unto them, Every kingdom divided against itself is brought to desolation, and every city or house divided against itself shall not stand.
A nation that is divided would surely fall. The United States of America are a divided States of America. There is nothing united about the USA. Satan is deceiving the inhabitants in the USA that their nation is united. When the people become dependent on the government, they become trapped. The workers of iniquity enforce their agenda through desperate people looking to save their family and themselves. Israelites, can you discern the purpose of the stimulus? The stimulus check and all government assistance programs are a trap. Many people took the government bailouts in the wake of the so-called pandemic. Now the so-called elites are predicting an economic collapse. They are predicting an increase in infections and foreclosures would increase. Israelites, do not allow anyone to speak death into your life. The scripture said death and life is in the power of the tongue.
Death and life are in the power of the tongue, and they that love it shall eat the fruit thereof.
Israelites, the elites can predict these things because they plan for these things to happen. Do not allow anyone to curse you with their words. Death and life are truly in the power of the tongue. Everyone should be familiar with the trials and tribulations are a blessing in disguise. If you endure to the end, a blessing and new beginning awaits you. Trials bring change and growth. When you mature and pass the test, you elevate in your spiritual walk. When the iniquities of a person or a nation has reached its peak, this brings forth the judgment of the Most High. The iniquities of this generation are at an all-time high. Do not be surprised if the Most High allowed the synagogue of Satan to target the indigenous black people because of their unrepentant ways. During the times of Noah, the people were wicked. The sons of God, the fallen angels, took the daughters of men for wives.
And it came to pass, when men began to multiply on the face of the earth, and daughters were born unto them, that the sons of God saw the daughters of men that they were fair, and they took them wives of all which they chose.
The Most High forbid angels to marry in addition to mate with the daughters of men. During the times of Noah, every intent of the people's heart was to do evil. The earth was full of violence.
The earth also was corrupt before God, and the earth was filled with violence. And God looked upon the earth, and behold, it was corrupt, for all flesh had corrupted his way upon the earth.
The Most High's creation was in rebellion. The people did what was pleasing to their flesh. The wickedness of the people caused the Most High to repent.
And God saw that the wickedness of man was great in the earth, and that every imagination of the thoughts of his heart was only evil continually. And it repented the Lord that he had made man on the earth, and it grieved him at his heart. And the Lord said, I will destroy man whom I have created from the face of the earth, both man and beast, and the creeping thing, and the fowls of the air, for it repenteth me that I have made them.
The Most High judged Noah's generation for their rebellion. The judgment that rained on the people during Noah's generation was the ending of an era to bring forth a new era. The Most High used Noah and his family as the foundation to the new era that began with the flood. The flood was a surprise to the workers of iniquity and all the inhabitants in Noah's generation. Today, the so-called pandemic is a surprise to many. Nobody would have thought one of the most advanced nations in this world struggled to deliver their people from the so-called pandemic. While the nations the elites consider third world controlled the so-called virus and delivered their people from the biochemicals the workers of iniquity unleash on the people. In the midst of a pandemic, the people in this generation are business as usual. They believe this too shall pass. Instead of preparing, many are carrying on as if a new era is not about to start. Like in every generation, the people do not have an ear to hear.
And God said unto Noah, the end of all flesh is come before me, but the earth is filled with violence through them, and behold, I will destroy them with the earth. And behold, I do bring a flood of waters upon the earth to destroy all flesh wherein is the breath of life from under heaven, and everything that is in the earth shall die.
Due to the wickedness in the heart of men, the Most High judged all flesh and destroyed the world with a flood. The Most High saved Noah and his family. Noah was found to be righteous among the heathens he lived among. Today, the signs are in the atmosphere.
And I will show wonders in the heavens and in the earth, blood and fire and pillars of smoke. The sun shall be turned into darkness, and the moon into blood, before the great and the terrible day of the Lord come.
The only way to see the signs, the Most High must open your eyes to see. Some will take heed and listen to the Most High. The awakening is evidence that some Israelites are listening and following instructions from the Most High. The population of the Most High's people returning to serve him in the spirit and in truth is small compared to the population that accept the beast system's deception. There are many Israelites trading their glory for the lesser in the church. The scripture said, broad is the road that leads to destruction. Many are on that road.
Enter ye in at the straight gate. For wide is the gate, and broad is the way that leadeth to destruction. And many there be which go in thereat.
In the midst of a pandemic, Israelites and heathens are living their everyday lives as if they are immortal. The Most High is sending all kinds of warnings to his people. The Israelites that are lost in the beast system continue to seek the approval of the heathens. In addition, they continue to set aside the will of the Most High to place a heathen over them. Many Israelites believe their heathen king can lead and protect them. The people that are persecuting you cannot save you. Satan cannot cast out Satan. If he did, his kingdom would fall.
And if Satan cast out Satan, he is divided against himself. How shall then his kingdom stand?
Too many Israelites want to become one with the workers of iniquity. The heathens and some Israelites believe they have time to do as they please. The people are starting businesses, having children, traveling, and keeping themselves entertained. The people are purchasing material junk that do not serve them, while the workers of iniquity are preparing for the upcoming destruction upon this generation. The workers of iniquity are building bunkers, quitting their CEO jobs, and shutting down businesses. Our present situation is as follows. The grocery stores are half empty. There is a lot of restrictions on our lives. Martial law is in effect. The workers of iniquity disguise martial law in the form of state emergencies and the pandemic that restrict you from traveling and shutting down the economy. The people cannot seem to see the destruction that is at their door. The synagogue of Satan is programming the people to accept the new normal. The workers of iniquity are plotting their next move, while the people are waiting for the so-called pandemic to pass. They are hoping to resume their life by picking up where they left off, just as the scripture said, as in the days of Noah.
As in the days that were before the flood, they were eating and drinking, marrying, and giving in marriage, until the day that Noah entered into the ark, and knew not until the flood came, and took them all away. So shall also the coming of the Son of Man be.
The people were partying, getting married, and dismissing the Most High's warnings. Nobody in Noah's generation stopped to look beyond their flesh desires to see what was upon them. The people were unrepentant. Their wickedness continued to increase. The inhabitants in Noah's generation continued to indulge in activities that gratify the flesh. The kingdom of darkness blind their eyes with the lust of the flesh that they could not see the end of their generation. I am sure they believed they had plenty of time to do as their heart desired. The flood that destroyed Noah's generation had no mercy on the inhabitants living on earth. One person was found to be righteous. The Most High saved that one righteous man and his family.
But Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. These are the generations of Noah. Noah was a just man and perfect in his generations. And Noah walked with God.
If you are not serving the Most High in the Spirit and in truth, do not assume you are inheriting the coming kingdom. The Most High used Noah and his family to replenish the earth.
And God blessed Noah and his sons and said unto them, Be fruitful and multiply and replenish the earth.
The Most High do not need billions of people to replenish the earth. The Most High used Noah, his sons, and his sons' wives to replenish the earth. Today, the world population is at an estimated 7.8 billion people. Yah used one family to replenish the earth. Let that sink in. Yah said, when two or three are gathered in my name, there I am in the mix of them.
For where two or three are gathered together in my name, there am I in the midst of them.
The Most High did not say he needs millions of people or a multitude. Yah only need a few. The Most High have a habit of using a single family to show himself strong through. Adam and Eve, Abraham and Sarah, Jacob, Leah, and Rachel are a few examples. Religion is deceiving the people to believe they will inherit the coming kingdom simply because they believe in Jesus Christ. We are living in a time where religion overrides the words of the Most High. Remember, Israelites, religion is not of the Most High. The Christian faith have an estimated 2.1 billion believers. About 86% of the world's population have some sort of religious faith. All these people believe they are being saved. The scripture said, narrow is the road that leads to life. Only a few would find the narrow road.
Because straight is the gate, and narrow is the way which leadeth unto life, and few there be that find it.
I hope the Holy Spirit is opening your spiritual eyes to see how narrow the walk with the Most High is. Yah found Noah in his generation. The Most High could not find one righteous person in Sodom and Gomorrah. Yet in this generation that has an estimated population of over 7 billion, many believe they would inherit the coming kingdom. This generation's wickedness is no different from the times of Noah and Sodom and Gomorrah. Too many people are hiding their filthiness behind self-righteousness. In Noah's generation, one man was found to be righteous out of all the inhabitants living in his generation. Keep in mind, Israelites, the people living in Noah's generation lived long lives. The scriptures reveal Noah was 500 years old when he had Shem, Ham, and Japheth. Noah was 600 years old when the flood came.
And Noah was 500 years old. And Noah begat Shem, Ham, and Japheth. And Noah was 600 years old when the flood of waters was upon the earth.
The scriptures does not reveal the world's population during Noah's generation. I believe the population during Noah's time exceeded our generation's population because the people lived longer than the average person living today. The Most High only found one person serving him. The Most High saved Noah and his family. The Most High could not find 10 righteous people in Sodom and Gomorrah to save those cities.
And he said, Oh, let not the Lord be angry, and I will speak yet but this once. Peradventure 10 shall be found there. And he said, I will not destroy it for 10's sake.
Somehow this generation, despite of their wickedness, believe if they confess Jesus, they will inherit the coming kingdom. If an estimated 86% of the world's population have some sort of faith and 14% does not, the scripture said broad is the road that leads to destruction. 86% is greater than 14%. Who is on the broad road? Let me remind you again that religion is not of the Most High. Israelites, the wicked category has no color, bloodline, or statue. Anyone from any bloodline can fall into the wicked category if they do not submit to the will of the Most High. Noah and his family were saved because Noah served the Most High. There are many in this generation pretending to serve the Most High. In addition, many are led to believe they are serving the Elohim of Israel in religion, and they are not. If you transgress the laws of the Most High and do not take heed to his statutes and commandments, you are wicked, regardless if you are an Israelite. There were no Israelites in the times of Noah. Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob were not around when the Most High judged the earth in Noah's generation. The new generation that came was the foundation to the new era the Most High started using Noah's sons and their wives. Being an Israelite will not save you from the judgment of the Most High if you are found to be wicked.
And it shall come to pass that whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be delivered. For in Mount Zion and in Jerusalem shall be deliverance, as the Lord hath said, and in the remnant whom the Lord shall call.
Israelites, it is important to examine yourself and recognize the times we are living in. The scripture said the Most High will speed up the times for the sake of the elect.
And except those days should be shortened, there should no flesh be saved. But for the elect's sake, those days shall be shortened.
It is wise for you to prepare and allow the Most High to order your steps in the critical times we are living in. Do not ignore the signs. Listen to the voice of the Most High. The Most High gave Noah time to prepare before the flood. Despite of not knowing when, where, and how the kingdom of darkness will usher in their abominations, it is wise for you to prepare yourself and family. Do not sit around believing everything would return to what it used to be. Do not fall under the illusion that quarantining is meant to save you from the pandemic. If quarantining, social distancing, and wearing a face mask was to help save lives, there would be no new cases, there would not be another shutdown, also an urgency to vaccinate the people before they could return to work, sending their children to school, and leaving their house to purchase their daily essentials. You must be vigilant. The scripture says Satan roams the earth seeking whom he could devour.
Be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about seeking whom he may devour.
Nothing the kingdom of darkness is preparing is beneficial to you. When the Most High used their abominations against them to judge the earth, do not get caught in the crossfire. Listen to the voice of the Most High. Do not be like the inhabitants living in the times of Noah. You must recognize the ending of one era and the beginning of a new era. When the wickedness of the people increases, the judgment of the Most High is upon the earth. Change comes through trials and tribulations. The kingdom of darkness will do everything to get you to submit to their abominations. Make sure your faith and trust in the Most High overrule their intimidations and deceptions. Israelites, despite of what it may appear to be, trust the Most High. Make sure you are found to be among the righteous in your generation.
And these are the words that the Lord spake concerning Israel and concerning Judah. For thus saith the Lord, we have heard a voice of trembling, of fear, and not of peace.
Ask ye now, and see whether a man doth travail with child. Wherefore do I see every man with his hands on his loins, as a woman in travail, and all faces are turned into paleness? Alas, for that day is great, so that none is like it. It is even the time of Jacob's trouble, but he shall be saved out of it.